Hello, everybody. I am a little bit drunk, but I think I have a good idea. I will not drink on stream. Not great. But, so, when a cube becomes unusable, there needs to be a wiggle. Some sort of do that allows the user to know when something has failed. Their input is not correct. So, oh no. This might. Okay. It's a problem for another day. We have a cube rotator. So we need a fail ease. If a cube fails to rotate, we got a wiggle. We have a quaternion that gets passed in. So that should give us the direction of the rotation. But it's going to follow a different easer. We'll have a different start. Ooh, target. The target rotation is going to be the same. That could be a big problem. Interesting. So, we've got a wiggle. Let's start by defining a baseline curve. Ooh, that's data. That is the 0.3, 0.3. I'm not happy with that. Okay, so start at 0, 0, go to 1. How often will we wiggle? Do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll make it smaller each time. So let's go to here. Not bad. Value is 0.5. No, 0.5. And then 0.2. What? Oh, come on now. Point two. There we go. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So at 0.4, value is -0.4. Oops. Oof, that was very close. Time is 0.4. So at 0.6, we go to 0.3. Value is 0.3. Shift tab up, 0.6. And then negative 0.2 at 0.8. Wow, right on the money, 0.8. And then at 1, 0. This is definitely not the curve that I imagined. I think it's going to get closer to the end, but it's a good start. So this is our fail curve. God damn it. I drank on stream. Okay. So, when this fails, ooh, those are two very different cases. If it's easing, I do nothing. If I cannot rotate, I fail. And, ooh, do I return? Nope, here's a check can rotate. So I'll start this bool off as can rotate. And then if can rotate this frame, ooh, I don't return here. I break. If we're easing, yeah, we're out. No user feedback. If cannot rotate this frame, and you know what? Let's do it Yoda style. So we have our curve. And the curve can be almost, we'll say, any direction. Rotate by. Oh, Jesus. If we cannot rotate this frame, I know I'm going to have to return, but I'm really just delaying the inevitable difficulty of this easing. Oh boy, this is very tricky, but useful. So I will persevere. I will continue to try. Okay, so let's think about it from the beginning again. I try to move it in a direction. The cube decides that it cannot move in that direction. So what it does is it wobbles across that axis, down to zero. We're going to have to use an unclamped lerp here. What does this even do? Lerp unclamped. There we go. So in this case, the start rotation and the target rotation are the same. Oh no. So I want to go. This is very different. Ooh, spirit linked. Oh boy. Oh boy. This is very tricky. Okay. You know. I'm just going to keep working. And if I'm wrong, so be it. Okay, so. Failed rotations. Okay. Yeah, let's do that. Let's make this the simplest possible. Oof. Not easy. Okay. Let's make a locked cube. So, this is a locked cube. The rotator is off. No, I lost all that work. Let's just start here. .33. Negative 0.1, 0.5. Point 1, point 6. Value is negative 0.5. Whoa! Hey! Negative 0.5. Oh, damn it. Sure, whatever. 0, 1. We can change the curve later. Okay. So this is our fail curve. We cannot rotate. Update cube rotation. Lerp unclamped. Start rotation, target rotation, output curve. Where does this output curve get used? I need to change this output curve to give us that wobble. Let's do a big old control shift S, F. Update delegate curve output. Look at how short that is. So we've got a curve here. Curve output. Ratio. Set curve. Timer over duration. And this is an unclamped lerp. Do some control minuses. Where were we at? Wait, so if it's easing, quit, sure. If it cannot rotate, what don't you like about this? What? Cannot convert from transform ease to unity.animation curve. Get curve, sure. Set curve would be easer get curve. Oh, rotate by needs to be nothing. Oh, no, it can't be nothing. There needs to be the direction in which the user swiped. I need to test this one small step at a time. Good old print. Let's turn off our locked cubes, or actually turn on lock spin when occupied. What? Can rotate is false. So let's add a tint. Okay. Change on start. Face container. And let's drop this in our special cubes, a locked cube. Okay, so we got the cannot rotate. That is good. We arrived in here. Easer. Easier begin ease. Sure, let's see what happens. Begin ease didn't work because I have no update and complete. I shouldn't return. I should just let the game do its work. Ho! Goof! Shit. Okay. Not bad. Not great, but not bad. So, turning it down. Turned off that face. I need to turn that face back on. On rotate complete. Let's just try something a little bit more interesting. It's not bad. Oof, yeah. I think that's pretty nice, actually. Damn it! Oh, two times. Two times mistake. Okay. So, if I rotate a locked cube towards a face that is occupied, how do I turn that off? On begin rotate. This is our begin rotate. Where do we turn that off? Begin rotate, rotate selected. This is our cube controller. Can be rotated. Rotator. Oh, hey, what happened there? Can be rotated. So let's call this, it's a good name for this. Where it can be rotated a little bit. No. Rotatable. So we return the rotatable value. Oh geez, can be rotated this frame. I've lost myself. Can be rotated. Search through all the delegates. Break out of the loop. Let's see what happens, huh? Should be the same. Damn it! Failure. Locked cube can rotate. That should not happen. Did that not happen? That did not happen. Or equals. Damn it. Okay. We got a lot of issues here, people. So if it cannot be rotated, I returned earlier, didn't I? What happened here? What did I used to do? Can be rotated. Ooh, that's a lot of... I'm gonna copy this just in case. We set the curve, begin ease, return. This should work in theory. Okay. I'm going to take a short break. Short break. I really don't think anybody's watching this anyway. But on the off chance that they are. But 3.5 minutes. Okay. Reassess the situation. Boom, fail. So that is because the rotate by is turning off the face. Target rotation is actually 0. Let's see what happens. If I set it to an identity. Still fails. So I need to find out why this face gets turned off. Why do you get turned off? Even if my target rotation is nothing before the curve, oh, hey. Rotate by. It's not going to turn at all, is it? Yeah. So I'm going to need two separate values, right? I'm going to need the, what's a good way to name this? The intended rotation versus the actual rotation. Okay, so intended rotation . So here, the actual rotation is the intended rotation is rotate by, and actual rotation is identity. So that means here, actual rotation is rotate by. Oh, this feels bad. Yeah, this is wrong. This is super wrong. That's okay. One step at a time. Okay. Rotate by. Well, this is so wrong. Let's see what happens. It's painful. Okay. Still the same. Start target rotation. It could be this begin ease. Rotator lambdas. Calculate cube rotate direction transform. Jesus. So I need it to wiggle, but not to turn off the faces. Hey, that could be a thing, cube face. Leaf node, sortation, validate. It's got to be in core. Calculate hidden faces. That's what I'm looking for. Has neighbor and face direction, current face. Who uses this? Handle begin rotate. Activate and break all paths. So we got a core. Damn it. Second time. Yeah. This is now a 21 and up stream. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry to all of the young people who watch the stream. Okay. So we calculate hidden faces. Get target rotation. Get start rotation. Get target rotation. Away. So when we set the target rotation here, we no, hey. Didn't actually rotate. Rotate by. So the start rotation and the target rotation must be preserved. Handle begin rotate. Calculate hidden faces. So what if get target rotation actually returned the actual rotation? Oh yeah! Check it out. Boom. Boom. Fail. 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 Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Yeah, bad news. Oh man, you can't rotate anymore. Which one is a three count? I believe it's green. Oh, fuck me. Sorry, that was pretty rude. Well, I solved one problem and created a lot more. Acceptable. Okay. Well, I done goofed, and I still have 6 connect perpendicular path warnings. Not great. But one step at a time, and this current step is a failure to rotate a cube. You know, we've got 9 minutes left. Let's make this more interesting, right? Five, 2.5. Half of 2.5 is 1.25. Ooh. No. That looks even worse. So let's move it to 0.8. How about this? This feels good. Let's see what happens if I move this bad boy. Ooh. That was correct. What? This is way off. That's so bad. What the big curse word. Value 0. What? Time 1, value 0. Is that why everything is so goofy? Whoa. Whoa. This is it. This is the last one. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. Solid. Okay, everybody. Slightly embarrassing. But I accomplished the goal that I sought to accomplish. So, if two or three of you watch this video, I will be shocked. Absolutely shocked. And I give you the full authority to make fun of me later.